Hello everyone, and welcome to my new video. Today I will explain to you how do you install a ChatLog mod on Minecraft 1.6.2. Now, because of the new launcher that was released with Minecraft 1.6, there's been a few problems, I can say, with installing mods, because the launcher automatically resets the jar file, so every mod you install is just lost. Now, that of course makes it very difficult to install a mod, so I'm just going to show you step by step how to install ChatLog with Minecraft Forge instead, which is much easier, and I highly recommend that you follow those instructions. It's easy. Now, the first thing you need to do, you need to download the Minecraft Forge auto install. You can find this in the link in the description or at minecraftforge.net. And when you go here, just click on files and select the, you see the top here, it says latest Minecraft 1.6.2. You need to verify the version of Minecraft. It always says here, so you don't install ChatLog in the wrong version of Minecraft. And also finally press down the installer link, which is under downloads. You will get to an add fly page. Just have to wait until you need to wait 5 seconds. There we go. And when it's done, just click this yellow skip add button, like so. I'm gonna save the file, and I already have it, but just save the file, okay, and the file will automatically download. So while we wait for Forge to install, let's go fetch ChatLog. Go to the link in the description, the Minecraft forum thread bit.ly/clmcmod. Scroll down until you find the downloads section. Click on get the mod for 1.6.2. You click here, save file, OK. Now downloads complete. So I'm gonna go to the forge I downloaded. Open it with Java. In Windows, you just normally double click the file, and just open it with Java. The Minecraft Forge installer will open. Select Install Client and press OK. Successfully install Client Profile Forge for version Forge 9.10.0.8 in the launcher. It might be a different Minecraft Forge version here, but successful. So I press OK. Now we go to the .minecraft folder. That's the only difference. You need to find the .minecraft folder. In Windows, you go to the Windows Explorer. You can press Windows button and R to launch run. Type %appdata% in the box that appears and press OK. I already showed you that in the other ChatLog video. That is a reference. You can just click on the pop-up right now. You'll see the video. In Linux, yeah, go to files or home, show hidden files, in right click, go to .minecraft. Here's the .minecraft folder. Now in .minecraft you need to go to versions and choose the one that says forge in it and the Minecraft version, so 1.6.2 forge, and open the jar file, which is on zip opener. You can use 7-zip for Windows. And now go back to downloads, take the class file we downloaded and remove it into Forge's jar. Also delete meta-inf, so it's hopeless to have the meta-inf there if you're installing a mod. So just delete meta-inf and close all the windows. Now we need to go back to the ChatLog thread. In the installation, look for Forge users. Some nice user managed to help me out in installing Forge with ChatLog. You need to copy these JVM arguments. We need them for later in the Minecraft launcher. That lets us actually play Forge with ChatLog installed. Now, open Minecraft, the launcher, and select from profile list, you need to select Forge, and log in if you haven't already. Edit profile. Now check the box that says JVM arguments. At the end, add a space and paste these flags. I also put those flags in the descriptions to make it easy for you. They'll always be on the Minecraft forum thread though. Save profile. Now finally press play. Minecraft will hopefully launch. Just wait a second. There we go. Minecraft launching. If I open up Minecraft again, here, just take a look. Go to single player, create new world. New world, okay. And the only way you can see the Minecraft, the ChatLog mod was installed successfully, that in the .minecraft folder, there will be. Waiting for Minecraft to start. Say something, and there will be a new folder here called ChatLogs. It will contain a file which is the year, month, and date matching down here. Open it, and you should see the message and the timestamp. And that's the only way you know that ChatLog has been successfully installed. Now, thank you a lot, guys, for watching this video. I really appreciate you from using my ChatLog mod, and I hope you will be with me later. Again, thanks so much, and see you, guys.